Well, Walmart announcing plans to hire more workers to meet demand. We know we've been talking about the rise in demand for a lot of these big retailers in the wake of the coronavirus outbreak. We have Julia LaRoche joining us now for more on the story. Julia?
Yeah, that's right, Seana. Well, if you go back to March 19th, Walmart said that it was going to hire 150,000 new associates. You know, a lot of this has to do with the demand that they're facing in their stores across those 4,700 stores in the U.S., but also just the fact that a lot of folks were out of work and they recognized that this is a retailer that has, you know, been doing quite well when it comes to the demand. And so they were trying to provide a bridge. They announced 150,000 within less than a month. They've already surpassed that goal. They are now announcing an even bigger goal. They're going to bring on another 50,000 people. That will make a total of 200,000. This is one of the bright spots. In the last 4 weeks, we've seen, 22 million Americans file for unemployment insurance. Here you have the world's largest retailer, the nation's largest private employer, stepping up. This is interesting. They've received 1 million applications. Most of them are coming from restaurant and hospitality. They specifically reached out to those industries. Also seen some folks coming from the retail industry. Now, 85% of the folks who have been hired are part-time or they're temporary at the moment. But Dan Bartlett, one of the executives there, told reporters last month that he expects some of these will morph into full-time jobs. So this is the story. We're trying to highlight some of the good news out there from corporate America, specifically stepping up when they recognize a time of need for a lot of people who are really hurting during this crisis. Seana?
Yeah, Julia, and it's interesting, too, because we've been talking about so many retailers who have been forced to do the exact opposite, who can't keep all of these employees on their payroll, who need to find other alternatives. They're either laying off their workers, furloughing hundreds of thousands of workers. So it's great to hear Walmart. And then, of course, their competitor, Amazon, is doing something very similar. They're trying to beef up their employees, their number of employees to keep up with demand as well.
Yeah, there's a list of them, including CVS as well. And I think one thing about Walmart, they are absolutely essential. I grew up in a small town. I think there's a Walmart within 90% of the U.S. population, within like 10 miles of the U.S. population. In my hometown, that is the grocery store. They are essential to so many different communities. So again, I think it's a great thing. You have Doug McMillon there, the CEO, the chairman of the business roundtable, someone who signed that letter around stakeholder capitalism. You're seeing him kind of front and center. You're seeing him on social media, out in these stores with their folks. So another bright spot. And when it comes to, you know, there's not that many right now that we're seeing. So you're seeing some folks, certainly some businesses really step up to help a lot of folks who are really in some dire need.
Yeah, and you talk about the staggering numbers that we've seen in jobless claims. So it's great to see more companies stepping up to hire because many people right now across the U.S. are looking for work. Julia LaRoche, thanks so much for bringing that to us.
Hey, investors, Zach Guzman here. Are you interested in learning more about the markets and getting the latest financial news? Well, then click right here to subscribe to our Yahoo Finance YouTube channel. Get the latest up-to-the-minute market analysis, big interviews in the world of finance, and information on how to manage your money every day, wherever you are.